If you have been playing D&D for as long as I have, you can get to the point where even their most exciting adventures can start to feel a bit repetitive, especially when it comes to combat. So in this video, we're going to try and tackle that problem when we talk about why your combat is boring because it's predictable, and give you 4 tips to make your combat less predictable. So the first tip I have is to use monsters that are more than just bags of hit points. What I urge you to do is try and use monsters that have more abilities. Instead of an ogre, you're using a frost ogre that can freeze the enemy in place. Anything that can really change up the battlefield, use more exciting abilities. As far as predictability goes, it's also a good point to try and either make your own monsters or go outside the box. Try out some third-party content creators like ourselves or Cobalt Press or whoever, who are creating monsters for 5e that your players may not have seen before, even if they have been playing for several years. Let them be surprised when the Medusa is not turning them to stone with their gaze, but instead are using slithering tentacles to grab their feet, pull them closer, and then turn them to stone through other means. My second tip is to change the goal of the combat. Way too often, the goal of combat in 5e Dungeons & Dragons is just to get the other party to 0 hit points before you reach 0 hit points yourself. And of course, there should be room for that, because that is, in essence, what combat is about. Kill the other guy before he kills you. But I would also urge you to try out other motives for combat. That could be escorting a very important person or object through the combat encounter, so you're not trying to fight the other side necessarily, you're trying to escape or get past them. It could be escaping a crumbling building before you die while someone are trying to stop you with violence. So it's not as much about defeating them as it is about getting out alive. It could be trying to stop the ritual before it is completed, so you're not necessarily just trying to defeat the other side, you're trying to defeat them while you're also making sure that the ritual is not being finalized. Another way to ensure that this is unpredictable is to also maybe change the goal of the combat midway through. So if the combat is starting to feel a bit stale, you can introduce a random element into the combat that makes it so that, okay, all of a sudden it's not just about defeating the other group of characters. And that could be as simple as the dungeon collapsing in the middle of the combat. It could be the ritual starting in the middle of the combat. Just keep it unpredictable. Make sure that the players don't always just know that, okay, we're just gonna hit each other until one of us dies. Another very important aspect of combat that is often overlooked is, of course, the battlefield. And as I've said in countless videos by now, I think that making sure that the battlefield is dynamic and a part of the combat is very important, and something that will make sure that one encounter does not look like any other encounter. So that's your pools of lava, that's your bridge across the narrow chasm, that's all those sorts of environmental hazards that can be in the battlefield and that can make sure that the players and the monsters can employ alternative tactics. Another thing here is they can also use these things to alter the battlefield while the combat is already going on. So the pool of lava suddenly begins expanding, a fire starts that begins spreading smoke within the chamber where the characters are fighting. Doing stuff like this mid-combat or at any point during the combat is something that will really help keep your players on their toes and make sure that they can't just expect the battlefield to remain the same throughout the fight. Another thing I love doing here is also giving the environment lair actions, even if it isn't a lair per se. So every round at initiative 20, something random will happen. Maybe I'll have every player roll a d20, and if you roll 5 or below, a rock drops on you and you must make a dexterity saving throw or anything like that. Just keeping the battlefield engaging and dynamic and changing throughout the combat is something that will really make your combat less predictable. Finally, I'll also advise you to introduce new challenges throughout the combat. Not only is this a good thing in terms of balance, because it can help you turn a boring, too easy encounter that should have been hard into an actual hard encounter when you introduce enemies or challenges later in the combat. It's also something that will make sure that combat is less predictable, because if you're fighting a bunch of goblins, you're doing pretty fine. That's a pretty easy, maybe not too exciting combat, but then all of a sudden an ogre mage come charging in and suddenly this is a very different combat. It doesn't have to be something you do every combat, because that'll get repetitive as well, but it's something you should keep handy for those combats that end up being less exciting than you wanted them to. If the villain is going down so fast, maybe that's where he suddenly summons a demon that can come into play, and just make sure you have that demon stat block ready for when you need it, because introducing that element of random, that new challenge in the middle of the combat, is something that will really help make your combat less predictable and help you balance an encounter that would otherwise have been too easy. So yeah, those are my tips for making sure that your combat isn't too predictable, because after all, it's been what, 7-8 years playing 5e Dungeons & Dragons now, and if your players are starting to feel that it's a bit repetitive, if they are veterans of the game at least, this is a good way to make sure that it doesn't get boring for them. As I mentioned, one way to keep your players on the toes is to use monsters and challenges from books that are not the core rulebooks they may not have seen before. If you're in the market for those kinds of books, you can check out links to Wander's Guide to Merchant Magic and Milando's Guide to Magical Marvels in the description down below. These two books not only have a bunch of cool merchant shops, magic items, they also have a lot of monsters, hazards, and even whole adventures that you can throw at your players. Beyond that, there's not a whole lot left to say, except thank you so much for watching, and I hope that I'll see you in the next video.